some pressure. I like to wait to see how things turn out. If you apply some pressure.
Never lost. Alright? And if I'd have been in the back of his cab, I probably wouldn't have moaned or said a word. Okay? Now, what you should now be doing, however, and this is what the knowledge is all about, is improving your direction and your line. Now.
Well, the first thing you do on the knowledge is you learn the 320 routes and you learn where the routes cross over each other and you learn an area of a quarter of a mile at the beginning and the ending of each run.
Left into what's that woman's name? I'm struggling. What's that road?
Artinworth Street.
Left into Artinworth Street, right into Barnsbury Square, forward Barnsbury Street, left West Ham Lane, set down on the left.
You then move on to a whole series of oral appearances, one-to-one appearances with an examiner. They're very daunting because you have no idea of what the examiner is going to ask you.
My first appearance is quite nerve-wracking because you don't really know what they're going to ask you. And I think you study a lot for your MAT test and then more or less straight away you're up for your first appearance, which is totally different from the other studying that you've done.
Second appearance, I think, was more nervous than the first, because the first, I didn't know what to expect. But the second, I knew what I was going to, knew what to expect.
What will normally happen, you'll be given a time to see an examiner at the carriage office, which is the examining body. We'll normally have to arrive about 15 minutes before that time. The examiner, you will go into a little waiting room, very similar to the dentist or the doctor's. The examiner will arrive and he will call your name out. You'll follow him down a corridor, which used to be nicknamed the Corridor of Fear. You'll go into a room, there will only be you and the examiner in that room. And he will generally ask you between 4 and 6 questions. A typical example may well be, he might ask you the British Film Institute and you will tell him that it's in Stephen Street. He might then say to you, 20th Century House, which you might say is in Soho Square. He will then ask you to describe the route you would take from one point to the other, naming every right turn, every left turn. If you make any mistakes along the way, you will not be allowed to go back. At the end of the run, you won't be quite certain how good or how bad you've done. He'll just go on to the next question, and the next question, and the next question. The appearance normally takes about 15 minutes. Once it's finished, he will give you your card, your appearance card back with a score on the card. The score will indicate how well you've done. Obviously, if you get an A, that's excellent. If you get a B, that's good. If you get a C, that's average. If you get a D, you haven't scored. And if you get an E or a UG, you're in trouble.
Everyone's different. I feel a little bit nervous.
Sick. Sick, I feel sick.
Streets, we're not in America, we always put the street in at the end of it.
Right, Kinland High Street.
If you take the first two appearances and you end up with a D, it's very, very likely that you're going to be red line. And then what will happen is you'll be taken through the full array of 56 days, which is probably 14 months. And then you'll be red line and you have to do 56 days all over again.
Well, on my last appearance, my examiner did give me a few points that I didn't know, and then he asked me for the camouflage bar, and straight away I pulled it, and I said, oh yes, that's Wardour Street, it's called Low Profile now. He said, no, you was meant to say I can't see that, it's a joke.
It's just, there's helter-skelter. One minute you just feel, you feel good, you feel you've done enough, and then you go into the carriage office and you leave, and you think, you know what, I could do a whole lot more.
Well, you get other funny stories coming out. We had a story of a guy who turned up without his tie, completely forgot to put his tie on for the appearance. When it was a female examiner, when she asked him why he'd come without a tie, he just turned around. The first thought that came into his head, he said, well, I did have it, ma'am, but a dog snatched it out of my hand and ran off with it. I mean, a likely story, but that's what he actually said to her. There are just so many that it was hard to recall them all instantly.
My call of a partner was telling me the other day, he was telling me one guy went for his appearance, I think it was his second appearance, and it was near Christmas, and he said, happy Christmas to the examiner. And tried to shake his hand. Examiner wouldn't shake his hand, and he got a D. He got a D as well. So that just—but you don't know if that's true. Just don't know. So it's all types of stories. It's all types of stories that that go around. I try not to listen to them because don't want to get, you're nervous already, you don't want added pressure. What I've seen, yeah, I mean, you hear a lot of stories, What I've seen, it's like they've only got 10 minutes to really test your character for the next how many years. So they might throw something at you. It might be, you know, it could be a road to do with your background, or it could be a criminal court, it could have a criminal record, they might throw a call at you just to see how you react. And you know, if you rise to the bait, then you really shouldn't be doing the knowledge, because there's gonna be people in the back, getting in the back of your cab, that are gonna be calling you all sorts of names or like giving you rollicking. So I think they're doing their job, they're doing it well.
Yes, I've got
C,
so I'm delighted.
That was good. What did I say now? What did I get? I got my first run. My first run was from Battersea Police Station, and it was down to the FA headquarters, FA Association headquarters. My second one was, what was it? It was from Westminster Synagogue to Chelsea Synagogue. My third one was from McDonald's HQ down to Tower Pier. That's Tower Pier.
The train stations, Holborn Station, Chancery Lane Station, Holborn, to St James's Station on Broadway. He asked me Stockwell Station to Knightsbridge Station. He asked me St Paul's Station to Island Angel Station. I'm sure he asked me another one, but I can't remember what it is at the minute.
Then I got, I think it was McDonald's HQ down to Tower Pier. And what was the other one?
Battersea Police Station?
That's it, Battersea Police Station down to the FA headquarters, FA Association headquarters. That's all I got.
Okay, he's mixed them up as well then, you know?
Yeah.
How'd you get on? All right?
Yeah, I scored, got a C, so I'm happy with that.
Nice, well done.
Where's Battersea going again?
FA. Once they feel that you've shown an improvement, they'll drop you down to the next stage, which means you come back every 28 days or every month. When you're getting really good, they'll bring you in every 3 weeks. Once they think you've completed that part of the knowledge, they'll give you what's called a rec, which means requisition to be fit to be a cab driver.
Start all over again. What happens when you lose everything? You just start.